Many legacy applications are architected as large monolithic applications, potentially containing millions of lines of code, and over time can become difficult to maintain and upgrade. Among other issues, they also don't promote themselves as being easily scalable from either a performance or cost perspective. Today's modern applications are written in a manner such that the monolith is broken into smaller components based on features such as object domain model or business function. Each component can be deployed independently as a small application called a microservice. Because microservices encompass specific discrete capabilities, the larger application architecture becomes composable, which also facilitates extensibility. The Where for Dinner reference application is composed of several microservices, allowing it to be highly configurable. Add in Spring's incredible abstraction feature, and the application can become even more configurable without needing to change or add any code. Spring is at the heart of Where for Dinner, and it exploits several of Spring's most common features, all working together to create a unified architectural experience. As a common starting point, every Spring-based microservice in Where for Dinner utilizes Spring Boot, which in my opinion is probably the most significant feature to come out of Spring since its inception. Early Spring development was not nearly as easy as it is now. It required a developer to manually create and manage one or more Spring bean factories or application contexts, which is effectively what makes a Spring app a Spring app. In addition, the developer had to manually declare and configure several other components, such as database connections or business objects, either programmatically or more commonly using an XML configuration file. When your application is built with Spring Boot, the application context is automatically created and managed by the framework and attempts to dynamically create and instantiate components based on what it finds on the class path through a discovery and auto-configuration process. Auto-configured components can include objects such as database connections, REST API interfaces and implementations, and even your own business classes. With just a few annotations and maybe a configuration class or two, Spring Boot wires up your entire application, freeing you up to write your application code. So how does one invoke Spring Boot? In many cases, all you really need to do is create a static void main function, just like any other regular Java application, annotate it with the Spring Boot application annotation, and tell the Spring application to run. With just this small amount of code, Spring Boot is set into motion and your microservice is auto-configured and ready to execute whatever business function it needs to perform. So with Spring Boot as our catalyst, let's look at some of the microservices in Where for Dinner. Where for Dinner has three required microservices and some optional services that extend the application's capabilities. The first two required microservices, called Search and Availability, implement the application's APIs and consist of CRUD type operations on their corresponding domain objects. These are the APIs used by the UI application when we create and list our submitted searches and for retrieving the dining availability found within each search. Each of the microservices invoke a common architectural pattern of an API resource layer backed by a service and/or a data access object layer. As previously mentioned, Spring Boot is used to create the Spring application context and wire up all the application's componentry. This includes discovering the classes and interfaces that define the domain models and data repositories, as well as auto-creating the underlying database connection. It also discovers the REST API implementations and wires in the previously discovered data repositories. Both of these microservices also participate in a data streaming pattern, and the data source and data consumer classes are also discovered and instantiated, as well as the connection to the underlying messaging system. Lastly, it discovers security configuration options that can enable the use of an external authorization server, and security can be turned on or off at deployment time using a Spring profile. The other required microservice is the search processor, which is responsible for the actual searching. And just like the first two microservices, it also uses Spring Boot as its common starting point. The search processor also participates in a data stream and plays the part of, you guessed it, the processor. The search processor receives submitted searches from the search service, performs the search, and finally sends any restaurant availability it finds to a downstream data stream consumer microservice. This is how the availability service receives restaurant openings before storing them in its data repository. The discovery process finds the function that implements the processor and hooks it into the data stream. You'll notice that the processing function is wired up with a business logic object that is also automatically discovered and instantiated via its component annotation. There are other ancillary objects that are also discovered, instantiated, and wired in using the same component annotation construct. Lastly, the search processor has the option of using Redis as a caching system, and if enabled, a Redis template object is also created with the underlying Redis connection object. There are optional microservices, such as the notification service, which also participates in the data stream as a consumer application. It receives availability and can send out notifications in real-time emails. Its internal email components are also configured by Spring Boot. The crawler component is designed to scour the internet for open reservations and store them in a data store. Even though it is not considered to be part of the application's main API, it is an internal service accessed via a REST API and uses the same Spring Boot constructs to discover and wire up its API classes as well as other internal components. Regardless of the type of microservice we want, be it a REST API, a streaming application, a task-based application, or even just a command line app, Spring Boot can fit the bill to discover, initialize, and wire up pretty much any type of service we need. You probably noticed that I glossed over the finer details of the Spring features like data access and data streams and their underlying connection objects, as well as how web APIs are implemented. As I stated in the introduction video, I wanted to make sure these concepts weren't introduced in a silo, but instead articulated in context of the bigger architectural picture. Over the next several videos, we'll take a deeper dive into these features to give you a more complete understanding of how they work and how they enable an awesome developer experience.